right to the American people.
That was the president earlier tonight going after the fake news establishment media during his rally in Ohio earlier, and here with reaction, Fox News contributor Mercedes Schlapp. Former special counsel, and I hate to admit it publicly, friend of President Clinton and former Trident DMG, founder of Trident DMG, Lanny Davis, Salem radio talk show host. He's been at the White House, I guess, all week, right?
Yep. Helping to drain the swamp.
To drain the swamp sewer?
Trying to, yeah.
Yeah, we're all trying. you know, he goes public and the whole momentum shifts. It's like all the air is out of the balloon every time he goes to the people and talks issues.
No, there's no question about it. I think one thing that you learn in being in the swamp or the sewer or whatever we want to call Washington, D.C. these days is the fact that you live in that White House becomes a big bubble. And so you almost feel like you don't even have enough oxygen in the room and you need to get out. And one thing about Donald Trump is that he does get energized when he's with the American people. And I think like one of the issues, for example, in the terms of health care, selling that message about talking about the failings of Obamacare, the need for a better bill, pushing the Republican bill, the best messenger is Donald Trump. And so he had to use his bully pulpit to go out to these critical states like Ohio, like West Virginia, and take the message directly to the American people.
You know, Lanny, we've known each other for a long time, and I've always complimented you that Bill Clinton, under as much fire, I really appreciate the fierce loyalty you showed your friend. That to me is an admirable quality.
Thank you.
But more importantly, you ended up writing a book about the experience. And I've advised more people about your book than you would ever know. Tell the truth. Tell it all. Tell it early. Tell it yourself. Now, I think some of this Russia got a little extended because not all the information came out.
Well, President Trump would do much better if he told the truth. And I think I wrote a column that said, bring everyone together, list every meeting you ever had with any Russian, every document, every email. Let's get this out.
I don't think he had any meetings himself.
Once and for all.
At all.
In the Donald Jr. meeting, which you tried to explore with Donald Jr., would have been much better had he done all of that rather than a few more drips. But right now, the president is focusing on health care. And we Democrats are wondering whether the Republicans can get their act together and actually approve something.
We conservatives are wondering, too.
At the very least, we support Obamacare, but we think it needs to be fixed. And wouldn't it be great if Republicans and Democrats and if President Trump were to
I'm not giving you a free
that,
pass. The Democrats, should we be investigating, as Senator Grassley suggesting, Ukraine and a meeting of a paid DNC operative and a political report that says that the Ukraine was trying to influence our elections for Hillary and that the information was being passed back to the DNC and to Hillary Clinton's campaign?
Well, first of all, I am a fact person. I haven't seen any facts that suggest that any information
because
was
you're not
passed.
Watching the show enough, and nor do you read Politico. You knew about the fact on my radio show today. Stop.
So, no, I know about the story about a Ukraine consultant that was passing information to the DNC. I don't know anything about anything being passed.
No, a DNC staffer, paid staffer, met with the Ukrainian ambassador at the embassy.
And I said to you on the radio that if that happened, and I'd like to see evidence, I don't approve of that, but I don't think anything got passed along to the Hillary Clinton. To answer your question, Senator Grassley should be investigating what we know is a Russian corruption of our election and has been found to be a pro-Trump and anti-Clinton.
You notice how he went right from Ukraine, Larry, to Russia?
Yes.
He doesn't take his own advice in some way. I want to go back to IT and Wasserman Schultz and this IT guy of hers busting up these hard drives, trying to escape out of the country. It sounds like, with all due respect, Lanny, one of his best friends busting up BlackBerries with hammers, deleting emails, bleach bidding them, and everything else that she's done.
The deletion of the emails, which were under subpoena, is absolutely outrageous, and she got away with it. And, you know, Lanny talked about facts. 1997, it is a fact that the head of the FBI, Louis Free, wrote the then AG a letter, Jan Marino, and said if there is any reason for a special prosecutor, anyone, it is right now, referring to Chinagate. Mm-hmm. The guy that headed up the task force, Charles LaBella, also wrote Janet Reno a memo, said the same thing. It did not happen. She never appointed a special prosecutor, and the scandal pretty much went away. This is the kind of stuff that causes people like me who support Donald Trump to circle the wagons and say, look, if you guys really are concerned about these kinds of things, where were you then? Where were you on some of the other matters?
If Donald Trump fires Bob Mueller, what will you say?
It's his right to do so. That's what I'll say.
So you just mentioned Louis Freeh, and you would not have favored the firing of Louis Freeh for writing that memo, I assume.
What I'm talking about is the double standard. I'm talking about the fact that both of them were scandals.
Larry,
both of them were scandals.
What you just did was a double standard.
One has a prosecutor, one doesn't. What I said is he has the power to do it. I didn't say I would be approve of it.
If there's anyone out there watching, we just heard
No, you didn't.
I
said if there's anyone out there watching.
One more time. I said he has the power to fire him.
Listen to me. That was a double standard.
I didn't say it would be the appropriate thing to do. I said he had the power.
I rest my
case. Just as Clinton would have had the power to fire Janet Reno or anybody else.
By the way, Larry, are you going to defend...
No, you didn't.
Are you going to defend...
Hold on. Do you believe that a special prosecutor should have been appointed then?
I believe that the firing of the FBI director...
I didn't ask that.
I don't believe there was any evidence sufficient to appoint a special prosecutor...
I rest my case.
...regarding China.
Louis Freeh had the same kind of impeccable reputation...
Under subpoena, 33,000 emails deleted, bleach bit used... Hang on. BlackBerry smashed, and it gets worse and worse. And all of the lying that took place, Lanny, and the Uranium One deal, is that a Russia... collusion story?
The Uranium One deal. Let's start with the 33,000 emails that Larry threw out, which has no factual basis. Those were personal emails having nothing to do with the State Department.
But she didn't, no one saw those emails except for Hillary Clinton and her team.
James Comey said there were classified emails on the ones deleted.
Guys, if I'm surrounded by all of you, I understand that it's...
Go ahead.
It's three against one, so that's even. Hillary Clinton only deleted...
Only deleted
personal emails, just as Karl Rove and lots of other people used the RNC emails and deleted those emails.
James Comey said they were classified, some of them.
James Comey did not say that they were classified.
How much?
Yes, he did. The personal emails deleted.
Comey looked through.
I'm on a hard break.
None of them were hard classified.
So Lanny, should Hillary have been indicted?
Of course not. Mr. Comey and the FBI.
We have an investigation. John Solomon, an explosive report tonight. Spying abuses under the Obama administration. Sarah Carter. It's like Hannity and Combs redux. It's unbelievable. We'll continue straight ahead.
Word here is the entire FBI.